So the window now, we actually can export them. Okay, the name is window glass. So I export them as a separate object. So then I can put it into Unity and assemble them again. Okay, so just name it window glass one. Okay, making sure all the smoothing glue is on. So I'm actually just now deleting all of them. So I now have one wall, one floor, and one window. Let's look at the larger object like the platform. So this platform is actually done it, and actually the center of the people is here. What I need to do now is actually just move them back to the center. So probably just scale the number in. If cannot, right, you see the number. So if this problem when you try to transform or freeze the number, that seems the number will not follow. One of the way I suggest is actually you just use the snapping grip and just snap it to the center. Okay, so when you snap to the center, this one can actually export it, then export them and you actually don't need to worry about this. Okay, you actually also freeze them again, can become zero, and it doesn't matter. Okay, so the most important when you export, this must be at the center of the grid. So when I export this one, this is the deck platform. So just going to export it as okay, the name deck platform. So remember previous thing, all the second EV channel should be done first for all the object. So now I have this, and now I have the platform and the carpet. The carpet itself is gonna name it as carpet. Again, the carpet. Okay, so this one also, the pivot point is actually off now. We can use that. So what we can do with this one now is actually we can just modify the center pivot first. So we have some in the center, and then we go ahead and then turn on the snapping grid and then move them into the center. Okay, so double check, is it the center? Yes, it's the center. Okay, so we actually can do that. Then after this is done, just export them again. So I'm going to be going faster a bit on the exporting, and hopefully you guys can see the end, right? Only a few objects is only required for the entire scene inside the game engine. So literally I have a lot of things and don't need them anymore. If I were to, let's say, show you the table. So the table itself, I've got two tables here, and the tables is right in the center here. So literally here, if the say the number is wrong, okay, so what I do is actually go ahead and then move them to the center of the grid again. So it's like that, it's just very fastly you can actually get the pivot correct, and then export this as a table into the game engine. So table, so literally this is the only few objects we actually continue to export, and then the table I don't need. So literally I just want one chair. So what chair I'm taking, maybe this chair. This is chair 01. Okay, so now at the moment this one, double check, if I were to, let's say, turn to 00, will it be the center? Probably not very accurate, because now the pivot point is not following them like this. So what I do is actually, because it's already at the bottom ready, so I can just snap them to the center of the grid. And of course one thing I need to take off, right, is actually the chair. When you are at a spot, right, you gotta make sure it's not rotated. So you probably want to rotate it back to somewhere the center. So probably the previous modification actually rotated a bit, so now this is more like the centers. Again, you literally can always check back and step it to the center, and I get a chair. So over here I'm just gonna export this one as a chair, and I can delete the rest of the chair. So when I check, right, I got one chair, I got one table, so all these chairs I don't need anymore. So to show, illustrate how much asset I only need for this entire scene. And what else can I have? Probably a quick do a barrel. So the barrel, I have one barrel, one already. Notice here that actually is, because it's supposed to be correct, because I moved the floor already, but now the barrel looks is right in the center. So again, the best thing is actually using the grip, snapping the grip tool, so I can just move them to the center. Regardless of this number here, it's not a big issue. Okay, so just put it in the center and then export them again. Okay, this one I'll just export as barrel. Okay, barrel one, making sure everything's correct. Barrel one, and then when I check back, right, I can don't need all this barrel, because I can actually just duplicate them again and assemble them again inside Unity will be better, because then I actually can save a lot of memories by doing modular methods. So this is the barrel holder. Again, this one also is, I should move it to the center. So what I can do is just isolate them and just move them, because it's snap ready. move to the center here. Okay, making sure it's actually, it's not black, it's supposed to be center here. Okay, it's correct. Okay, then after that, I will just export this as a barrel holder. A barrel, whatever the name is, can't you remember what the name is? And it's easy for you to find the object again when you import into GameEngine. So, right, so this one is done. So now left with the real issue. I would suggest you probably want to put that as one piece instead, because if you try to export them one by one, I think it kind of feels a bit too small, because piece that's too small, we probably want to combine them. Example like that, I will show you the all these chips that I can actually combine them together as a group itself is better. And this kind of real thing is actually kind of like will be better to put it together as one piece. Okay, so what I did was this one is the real, so the name is real one. This one I'm going to just get moved in the center, and then when we export later, we import the game engine, we find out, let's say if it's not match the deck well, we actually can still change it. So we're going to put it real one. So now I have done this. Okay, so I have this. The last few things I have left is the, okay, this is the sofa. Sofa wise, check. Now the first, so sofa wise, if you notice here, the pivot point is kind of like way off somewhere in the middle here. So one of the suggestions I can put is actually just, you probably one can actually move the, okay, let's turn off this one and move this pivot point, move it to somewhere at the corner there, so it's easier for you to move. So this is our suggestion, that when you have this kind of object, right, which is the pivot is somewhere in the middle or somewhere is where there's no object, all right, it will be better you just to find the one of the location that you can actually can one of the maybe vertex or something, right, that actually has the center, and you just put it there to the pivot, and then it's easier for you to kind of mesh around, because once you put it there somewhere, right, it's easy for you to continue to duplicate them later on. So once I have this done, okay, just I want to move it to the center. I'll turn on the grip again, and then I'll just this one turn off the grip, snapping grip. Okay, so I'll just move it center here, and I'll export this as a sofa. Almost there, we're almost done already. They should have this almost all the object here. Last one, probably the last two objects, actually the bar table. Okay, the bar table is correctly. This bar table can maintain the same pivot point without moving them, and I just need to move them to the center before exporting. Okay, to double check again. Okay, exporting. So now I should just export this as a bar table one. Okay, the last thing, probably this is the only thing you have for exporting. The last thing is actually all this poker table stuff, right? So what I can do is actually, my suggestion is just export them as one whole. That way when you put them on the table, right, you can actually have a variation. Like if you want more, maybe you can just duplicate different version, because my suggestion is all this stuff right here is kind of too small to kind of like put them together, but you can actually export them together. It's a very small object, but it feels kind of too small to just export them and kind of waste memory. So modern methods, some words, right, if you plan it properly, and sometimes this kind of small object that we don't need to be too individual, we actually can combine them together and we export them as one piece. So this one links as a poker asset. So including the bottle lah. Okay, so probably want to move the pivot point slightly lower a bit. So slightly lower to the kind of their ground layer, okay, ground horizon. Then after that, I'll do is actually move them to the center of the grip. Can export them. Okay, export them as poker asset. So now I have this. There, okay, so they actually then I don't need all this ready, because this one is actually could be a duplicate of the another one. But if you want to put them as two design, it's also welcome, because it's just very simple polygon stuff, and sometimes this can be just put together as one piece, right? So you can actually put this as a poker asset design tool. So sometimes I'll do that also. So when this thing put together, combine, just put them poker asset, and then I just can move them to the center. But before that, making sure the pivot point is kind of like right in the ground level. Okay, then after that, turn on the snap grip and then move it to the center and export them. So exporting them as the same name as the poker asset, but change the number to 2. So they have, you know, it's a different variation. So by now, almost all is done. Left is probably the 2 bottles. So we actually can export them as separate also, as separate, like together, as the 1 bottle. So this one will be the bottles. Bottle 01. Okay, then after that, making sure the pivot point again is supposed to be where it's supposed to be. Okay, on the kind of ground surface here. And then after that, we go ahead and move the last object to the center of the grip and let's export them. Literally, we have exported all the stuff that we needed for the entire scene to export into the game engine. And that's literally all you need to do. You don't even need the characters. And by using this few asset that is left, right, and this is what you export into the game engine, and nothing more, nothing less, is good enough for me to create the modeler scene, okay, with all this asset here. So the next session, let's go to Unity, and then we actually can assemble all this scene together. Alright, then see you in the next video.